Hi friends, I know you came into this video by seeing the thumbnail and title, 1 hour newspaper reading challenge. Okay, this is the paper I'm going to study. I'm going to read the new Sunday Express. I can read the titles here. If I interested in the title, I'll go deep into that. Okay, I placed a stopwatch there. After 1 hour completing, I'll finish the video. So 1 hour newspaper reading challenge starts now. The new Sunday Express, Chennai Sunday, December 13, 2020, 8 rupees, 26 pages, late city edition, I don't know. Okay, let's read into the titles. Trump appointees voice no dissent. US Supreme Court rejects suit challenging Biden win. Reforms will break barriers, Modi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Saturday defined the reforms, saying they will increase farmers' income. If you place barriers in previous government did, an industry or sector cannot grow. The recent agriculture reforms are a part of the barrier breaking process, he said in his address to the annual general meeting of the FICCI. Farm leaders to sit on hunger strike tomorrow. Farmers take over 2 toll plaza in Haryana, Delhi Jaipur main road to be blocked today. Conflict of invest in government green panel. 4 killed as truck rams row of 12 cars near Dharmapuri. Hey Modi. Hi Modiji. Unrest at Kolar iPhone factory over alleged non-payment of wages. MHA ordered central deputation for 3 Bengal IPS officers. Express reads. And here's the big advertisement, half page. I'll go to next page. This is not interesting. And next page, yes, you can see the farmers. Meet the water investor who saves every drop. A Midas touch to waste. Cops help tribal youth scale new heights. The man in planting a revolution to secure the future of our planet. Half yearly exams in government school deferred. I don't know. Private schools to finish exams by December 24th so that students can have Christmas vacation. Oh my God. But why exams? Microchips for stray dogs inside IITM. Okay, in this page not interesting. I came to third page. Okay, I keep it that as is. Okay, half yearly exams in the government, it is quite interesting. Let's go into this. Private schools. Okay, did school education minister K.A. Sengotayan on Saturday announced the postponement of half yearly exams in government schools. Revised exams schedule will be announced later. Private schools, however, have decided to conduct the exams online. While the private schools have been conducting online classes, only report for the government school students were lesson broadcast on Kalvi TV. Schools in Tamil Nadu remain shut in fear of a second round of contagion. Government school students, who mostly hail from poor family backgrounds, may not be able to take the exams online. The government should resume in-person classes for at least class 12 students. They will be surely under prepared for public exams if they are not trained now, said Tamil Nadu Government Teachers Association leader P.K. Ilamaran. Okay, the government should announce the priority syllabus based on which public exam question paper would be set. It was announced that 40% of syllabus will be slashed, but we do not know it. He attended. Preparations for half yearly exams are already underway in private schools. The Tamil Nadu Matriculation Higher Secondary and CBSE Schools Association leader K.R. Nandakumar said the private school have agreed to complete exams by December 24th so that students can have Christmas vacation. We are expecting in-person classes to resume by first week of January, he said. This time there is more weightage for objective and MCQ questions. It is easier to test students online. Using this format, Nandakumar added, however, some schools have asked students to write exam and send scanned pictures within designation time after the completion of tests. Other schools are increasing the weightage of cumulative assignments and class tests in the exam total score. Express employee retires. Chennai. R. Vijay Kumar, who served as a grade 1 packer from Express Publications in Chennai, retired on December 10. Vijay Kumar has served in the publications packing department for 31 years. Nice. A sea of joy ride for metro commuters coming soon. Microchips for stray dogs inside IITM. You can make a point if I am reading wrong by the comment. Okay, the time is going, just 6 minutes have done, 54 minutes to go. Rajini fans celebrate birthday with party. Okay. 27 constitutions colleges bring under state government. 4 die in road accident near Thopur. Can NMC create additional seats in 24 colleges? What do you think? And can't hold it. Okay. Online ENGG classes will continue till April. Oh no. Oh my god, so sad. HC stalls working on Singanallur Lake. PMK protest a self-destructive or a gainful move. Give 30% increase to farmers for crop loss. Gold was kept in premises of Surana, clarifies CBI. Okay, this side also not quite interesting. So I go into this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th page I think. Where is the page numbers also not given? Ah yes, here's the page 5. This is not clear. Okay, no problem. 53 years old man arrested for murdering daughter. Oh no, so sad guys. Okay, it is quite interesting. Yeah, let's go into the deep. Couple planned to kill both daughters, sells over mountaining debt. Probing the suspicious death of a woman professor and her daughter in Taramani city police on Saturday. Arrested her absconding his husband and rescued their other daughter. Geeta Krishnan, 53 years, and his deceased wife Kalpana, who worked as a professor at the private college, decided to kill both his daughter and commit suicide as they were unable to settle their mountaineering debts. An investing officer said, No, I'm stopping this. This is not interesting. They are using difficult words. Okay. Protest notwithstanding, SM Nagar evictions continue. Water gushes out from lake, damages sluice gate. Dry weather condition to continue. Yeah, Chennai, dry weather. Chennai. The interval in the northeast monsoon is likely to continue till next weekend. The regional meteorological center said dry weather will prevail over the state, and only light to moderate rain is expected in a few places. Chennai sky condition is likely to be partly cloudy for the next 2 days, with maximum and minimum temperatures of 31 Celsius and 22 degrees Celsius respectively. This year monsoon has been very active, with the state so far receiving excess rainfall from October 1st to December 12th. Chennai received 44% excess rainfall. The city recommended 803 mm of rainfall as against the normal 643 mm. I can't understand. Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board, Highway Department, Chennai, Periprelving Road Project. Okay, move on to the sixth page. What is six pages? This is the sixth page. ஒன்றுமே புரியல. செவன்த் பேஜ், விஸ்ட்ரான் ஒர்க்கர்ஸ் கோ ஆன் ரேம்பேஜ் ஓவர் பேட் டியூஸ். வாட் இஸ் திஸ் இஸ் அ நியூஸ் பேப்பர் இஸ் திஸ் அ நியூஸ் பேப்பர் ஒன்னோ எய்த் பேஜ், யா ஹியர் இஸ் அ டைம் ஹியர் இஸ் யூ கேன் ரீட் சம்திங். Page number 8. Opinion. Okay, opinion page. Here's the opinion page. Spiraling sense. What? No. No. The Long March, Indian version. Too much democracy for Mandarins. This is not quite interesting, but no way. I have too much time remaining, so I need to go. Oh no, only 12 minutes have done. For your interest, I am going deep into this. Okay. In February, I'm reading from here after the line. In February, the authors of India's annual budget estimated India's GDP would touch around 225 lakhs crore in March 2021. India is currently in the technical recession, and the consensus in that India's GDP will be around 195 lakh crores. In February, the gap between expenditure and expenditure estimation at 7.96 lakh crore, and this widened by October to around 10 lakh crores. Indeed, the total fiscal deficit of center and state, which was 6.3% of GDP, is now estimated to be around 10.5%. Could be about 20 lakhs crore. It is true that frequency indications show improvement, and recent reports have forecast a better and earlier than expected recovery. This thought does not diminish the challenge faced by the government. It must find resources for priming the economy to propel growth to the level which ensures that high level of deflation and debt are sustainable. The question which begs to be asked is what the mola mantra for founding growth is. For sure, there is discussion about expenditure control, but the scope is limited given the need for government to fund investment and growth. Net deflect tax collected are low and ramping up collections is constrained. There is only so much that can garnered from an economy which is expected to contract by other 10% and which would take time to normalize. It is going long. No problem, I have much time. Intriguingly, INTRIGUINGLY. There is a mystifying. What? Why? What are you doing? Okay. Retentions to harvest the potential of raised revenue that disinvestments. Even as the stock markets and Sensex are spiraling, disinvestment is stalled. Consider the circumstance to appreciate the opportunity that has passed by 13 March 23 and December 11. The benchmark BSE has shot up from 26,000 points to over 46,000 points. Has the rise in the stock prices been leveraged? Sadly, that is not case budget. 2020 set a target of 2.1 lakh crore to be raised via disinvestment of obligation sector entities. New ETFs listening of entities such as LIC and strategy scales. As per the data put out by Department of Investments and Public Asset Manager, the total receipt from disinvestment in the current year is 6,533.11 crores. Consider the global context in 2020. Non-financial firms of the world have raised over $3.5 trillion from investors. DoorDash, the food delivery enterprises, which is yet to record profits, is valued at over $55 billion. Airbnb touched valuations exceeding that of Expedia and Marriott, with investing rates hovering below 1% of over $17 trillion locked in negative yield. Investors across the world are chasing returns. And India is also beneficial if one works at the portfolio flows. So why wouldn't the government list the Life Insurance Corporation of India? As indeed it promised in Budget 2020 to raise resources. Why not dilute government holding in banks below 50% to enable the government to enable better governance? Raise cash, recapitalize banks so they can face competition from new entrants. Take strategic disinvestments. For many for years, the go-to line of government has been disinvestment at the right valuation. The right approach is to focus on the net present value of resources, which can be realized, not just the preconceived valuation of what could be. Arguably, given the state of the economy and global trade, the scale of BPCL or Air India may be challenged. Why not shift government holding in a sovereign region fund and raise resource against asset from as debt and then cash from sales. Also offering can be segmented and disinvestment customized. Take the cause of pharma PSE on the list. The world is scrambling for production facilities. Why not offering plug and play opportunities to India pharma with global footprint and a toehold in the active pharma ingredient business? Why not invest transnational to partner? Why not offer them to global vaccine allowance GAVI? The economic cost of government running business is illustrated by data. It is not secret that a third of PSE are hammer hanging taxpayer monies. Between 2010 and 2009, the cumulative losses of public sector enterprises PSE were over 2.65 lakh crores Indian rupees at erroneous of public weather, which was worsening over before the pandemic. Between March 2010 and March 2020, the value of all listed companies rose from rupees 61.65 lakh crores to over rupees 113.48 lakh crores, whereas the value of listed PSEs split from rupees 17.34 lakh crores to 11.33 lakh crores. Sure, they have been sold, but they also have been new listings, and the going is bound to be together given the advent of ESG norms embedding by government investors. The economy consequences of COVID will be felt long after the pandemic has abated. The challenge before the government is longitudinal, immediate, medium and long term. It needs a playbook for how it will fund social and economic development. For starters, it may want to design a policy on PSEs. The political economy is at an inflection point. The pharmacies, Emily Dickinson, it is used to open over door to welcome dawn. Finally, I am done this. Oh my god. Oh no. Okay, I am going to the page number 9. 9? Okay, 8 to 9. Okay, nice. Farmers reforms will raise incomes, says Modi. This was going top in the newspapers. Okay, India is being tested, will meet border security challenge, EAM. How many sacrifices more? What? Under pressure, Haryana DYCM calls for talks. India will exceed targets beyond Paris Pact PM. No COVID effect on IIT job placement. Domestic companies offer 35% raise in pay package. Okay, this was quite interesting. Let's read this. The COVID-19 pandemic, first of all, Sumi Sukanya Dutta at New Delhi. The COVID-19 pandemic and subsequent disruption in the economy seems to have had little impact on ongoing place implement in the prestigious Indian Institute of Technology, where the annual pay package offered has risen by 30 to 35% as compared to last year. Placement in charge at several IITs said the payment of offers from domestic companies have overshadowed even top international offers, which means that many fresh graduates will earn more in the country than their batchmates who take up offer abroad. Less than 2 weeks after the placement season began, nearly 60% final year students in the older IITs have already got placement offers. At IIT Delhi, over 300 national and international firms offering more than 500 job files across multiple sectors have registered for hiring students this year on the first day of the first phase of final placement itself. Students have begun over 300 placements of offers, including pre-placement offers, with many beginning multiple offers. Also, around 150 PPOs, including international locations, were received. As per officials, companies from technology, banking and financial service sectors are leading the pack in hiring students, and a large number of students are happy as they are assured of jobs despite a downbeat job market. In IIT Bombay, a number of international firms has had lined up to hire graduates of which Dutch company Atrevid offer the highest pay package of rupees 1.39 crore per annum. Authorities at IIT Madras said the institution had begun nearly 750 offers, while this number was about 700 each in case of IIT Guwahati and Roorkee. Also, more than 220 companies have registered for hiring, more than any year so far. At the institution, nearly 190 students also got pre-placed offer. About 1,400 students are hoping for placed by the end of the placement season. But officials at IIT Roorkee, which is looking to ensure jobs for at least 1,200 students this season, said fewer offers were received this year as compared to the last year. A professor involved with the process, a placement of IIT Kanpur, said there is a good mix of companies from India and abroad from the varied sector, which is a very good sign. At IIT Banaras Hindu University, officials said more than 215 students have bagged jobs with annual package ranging from 11.5 lakhs to 64.27 lakhs. It was quite motivating. Yes, definitely it was quite motivating. Expert raise eyebrows on appraisal by unqualified EAC. Let's go into this. How much the time happened? 28 minutes done. Oh no, 29 minutes. I'll show you the time later. I'm going to this. Expert raise eyebrows on appraisal by unqualified EAC. Continue from page 1. I don't know, I didn't start in page 1. Let's continue from here. Other members, no, it will not get the point. Let's move. Yeah, it was new. Okay, I'm leaving that. Fertility rise falls in major states but rise in Kerala. Same. Sumi Sukanya Dutt at New Delhi. Even as the central has expressed its intent of adopting measures to control population growth, the total fertility rate in the large part of country has shown a considerable fall over the last 4 years. The phase 1 of National Family Health Survey NFHS 5 shows for 22 states of 5 for 22 states and UTs for which data has been released on Saturday, the TFR or children born per woman now stands at 1.76, while it was 2 during the NFS carried out in 2015-16. The TR of India was 2.2 in the last survey, just a notch above the replacement level of 2.1. Surprisingly, to Kerala, known as best human development indices in the country, is the only state where the TFR has increased. During NFHS 4, the TFR in the southern state stood at 1.6 but has now risen 1.8 and is the same in both rural and urban areas. There are two states, Telangana and Tripura, where the TFR has remained the same, while there has been remarkable drop in social indicator for most state including Bihar. The state with the highest TFR, the state now has TFR of 3 as compared to the last survey when it stood at 3.4. Also, Kerala and Goa are among 8 states where the SE ratio at birth has worsened while releasing the report. Union Health Minister Harshvardhan pointed out the present NFHS is being conducted in 6.1 lakh sample households, involving households level interviews to collect information on health and family planning related indicators. The result from Assam, Bihar, Manipur, Meghalaya, Sikkim, Tripura, Andhra Pradesh, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Gujarat, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh, Karnataka, Goa, Maharashtra, Telangana, West Bengal, Mizoram, Kerala, Ladakh, Lakshadweep and Dadranagar, Haveli and Daman, Diu have been made public as phase 1 and phase 2 of the survey covering the remaining 14 state of UTs. UTs, however, had their field work suspended due to COVID-19, but have been resumed from November 14 and is expected to complete by May. Sustained improvement in maternal and child health indicators over NFHS was reported in the present survey, said the minister, adding that contraceptive use has increased and unmet need has been reduced in most phase 1 states. The survey almost found considerable improvement in vaccination coverage among children aged 12 to 23 months across all states and UTs covered. The survey almost found that for the first time, women with bank accounts have been recorded separately. Okay, what is the time? 34 minutes 45 seconds. Let's move on to the 10th page, Chennai. 34 minutes we have finished, guys. It is very hot. Please do subscribe. It is easy for you, but it is first time for me and it is very hard. For this hard work, you need to be subscribed. Okay, in the 10th page, India news. Top brass of Kong skips DDC poll campaign. Mamata furious as MHA summons three IPS officials. Ghar Vapsi for Raj politician Ghanshyam Tiwari. EC official to visit state next level next week. EC official to visit state next week to take stock of situation. Bodo council elections likely to throw up fractured mandate. FIR against man as minor girl accused him for forcing to convict for wedding. Haryana government wants MPs, MLAs include in COVID-19 vaccine priority list. 214 students of IIT IISM terminated. High level probe into death in MP hospital, Bhopal. Okay, this news is quite interesting. FIR against man as minor girl accuses for him forcing to convert for wedding. This is Namita Bajpal, Lucknow. AMID controversy over the recent anti-conversion ordinance in the state. A minor Hindu girl lodged a complaint against a Muslim man, accusing him of forcing to her convert to religion if she wanted to marry him. The case has been registered in Shahabad area to Hardio district. According to people sources, the man was booked under the Uttar Pradesh prohibition of unlawful conversation of religion ordinance 2020. The Indian Penal Code and the Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act. Hardio Superintendent of Police SP Anurag Watts confirmed that the FIR was registered against a person identified as Ajad. The SP said that minor girl had claimed in her complaint that she and the accused were in relationship for the past 2 years and the man had promised to marry her. The SP said the complaint has accused the man of putting the condition of conversion to Islam just before the wedding day on November 13. The IPC section of rape has been included in the FIR as she alleged that the accused sexual priority her on pretext of marriage, the SP said. Ever since Uttar Pradesh anti-conversational audience came into began on November 28, around 6 to 7 cases have been registered under it. Last week also, a wedding between a Hindu girl and Muslim boy was stopped in Lucknow by the police authorities despite the consent of both the families. The couple was asked by the police authorities to approach the district magistrate and inform him that it was going to be an interfaith marriage and that there was no forcible conversation. Last Saturday, a Muslim man and his brother were healed in Moradabad after he tried to get married to a Hindu woman. The woman reportedly told him police that she was getting married of her own free will. I didn't understand anything. If you understand, please keep it to yourself. Okay, this paper is done. 7, 8, 9, 10 pages. Okay, here's the 11th page. Still 20 minutes are there. Yes, we can do it. Page number 11. We are going to start. This is worldwide news. Just now I am getting this. Worldwide news. WORLD. Trump barked TAX's lawsuit on poll result hits a dead end. What? Trump backed TAX's lawsuit on poll result hits a dead end. Washington. The Supreme Court has rejected a lawsuit backed by President Donald Trump to overturn Joe Biden election victory, ending a desperate attempting to get legal issues rejected by state and federal judges before the nation high court and subvert the will of voters. Trump bemoaned the decision late Friday, tweeting, "The Supreme Court really let us down. No wisdom, no courage." Oh no, Donald Trump? You did that or you are admin? The High Court order earlier Friday was a stark repudiation of legal claim widely regarded as dubious, yet embraced by the president, 19th Republican state attorney general and 126 houses publications. Trump had invested the court would find the wisdom and courage to adopt his baseless position that was election was the product of widespread fraud and should be overturned. But the nation's highest court emphatically disagree. Friday order marked the second time this week that the court had rebuffed Republican request that it get involved in the 2020 election outcome and reject the voters' choice. As ex-president in an election regarded by both Republican and Democratic official as free and fair, the justice turned away an appeal from Pennsylvania Republican on Tuesday. Trump had called the lawsuit filed by Texas against Georgia, Michigan, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin, the big one that would end with the Supreme Court undoing Bidening substantial electoral college minority and allowing Trump to serve another 4 years in White House. Oh no. In a brief order, the court said Texas does not have the legal right to sue those states because it has not demonstrated a juridical cognizable interest in the manner in which an other state conduct its elections. Justices Samuel Alito and Clarence Thomas, who have said previously the court does not have the authority to turn away lawsuits between states, said they would have heard TAXA complaint, but they would not have done as Texas wanted, setting aside those four states' 62 electoral votes for Biden. Pending resolution of the lawsuit, Trump complained the witness within a flash. Trump complained that within a flash, the lawsuit was thrown out the gone without even looking at the many reasons it was bought, a rigged election fight on. The three Trump appointees sit on the high court in his push to get most recent of his nominees. Justice Amy Coney Barrett confirmed quickly. Trump said she would be needed for any post-poll lawsuits. Barrett appears to have participated in both cases this week. AP. Okay, worldwide we have one interesting news. US COVID-19 vaccine to start arriving in state on Monday. Oh no, tomorrow. Only 15 minutes to go. Finish. Washington. Paining, you know. The US FDA authorized emergency use of the nation's first COVID-19 vaccine late Friday, and Americans will start receiving the Pfizer BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine from Monday. After shipping on Sunday, the official in charge of the distribution said, expect 145 cities across all the states of receiving vaccine on Monday, another 425 sites on Tuesday, and the final 66 cities on Wednesday, which will complete the initial delivery of Pfizer BioNTech vaccine, said General Gus Perna. Initially, 3 million shots are expected to be shipped nationwide. It was unclear exactly who would receive the first dose of the vaccine. Through health workers and nursing home residents were the proper priority. Perna said health authorized would decide. The FDA decision on emergency authorization of Pfizer BioNTech vaccine came only after public review of data from a huge ongoing study. But the agency has also been dogged by intense political pressure from the Trump administration, which has accused it of being too slow and even threatened to remove FDA chief Stephen Hahn if a ruling did not come on Friday. The FDA decision followed tense discussion between White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows and FDA Commissioner Stephen Hahn, according to senior administration official who was familiar with the call but was not authorized to discuss private conversation. The Chief of Staff told Hahn his job was in jeopardy if the emergency cause authorization was not issued before Saturday, said a second administration official familiar with the conversation. Earlier in the day, Hahn had issued a statement indicating the agency was working rapidly to clear the vaccine. Dr. Ashish Jha, Dean of Brown University School of Public Health, called the pressure an unforced error by the White House that could chip away at the public confidence in a vaccine. It creates a veneer of political meddling, Jha said. every time you see the president get involved, you can you see vaccine confidence drop by 10%. Han and other top health officials have been working for months to boost public confidence in the vaccine effort, which will eventually need to reach most Americans to suppress the virus. Okay, that 11th page is also done. Here's nothing. Some bank classified something they given. And the 12th page, we got this Modi back. Oh my god. Business page. The 12th page is business page. BUSINESS. Okay. Economic recovery faster than expected. PM Modi. Is it? No. It's fake. The media smothered and Marijuana trial we all want to forget. What? This topic is quite interesting. What is economic recovery faster than expected? PM Modi said. Okay. Highlights record foreign investment inflows seen during pandemic. Highlighting the improvement in economic indications, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Saturday said that the ongoing recovery has been faster than expected with the situation much better than it was in March. We have answer as well as a roadmap. The things learned by the nation at the time of crisis have further standing the resources of future. The credit goes to Indian entrepreneurs, youth farmers and citizens. Modi said while speaking at the FICCI annual general meeting, talking about green shoots in the economy and the trust shown by investors. He said that India has seen record for foreign direct investment and foreign portfolio investment during the pandemic. The faith that the world placed on India in the last 6 years have further strengthened in the past few months. Be it FDI, foreign direct investment, or FPI, foreign portfolio investment, foreign portfolio investors have made record investments in India or continuing to do that, he said. The government, he added, he also taken many initiatives in almost all sectors to ensure reforms. From manufacturing, the MSME or agriculture to technology, there has been all around reforms, and corporation tax is the most competitive in the world. Be it mining, defense or space, new opportunities are popping up, and in a vibrant economy, when one sector grows, it impacts other as well. Modi said. Corporates, he said, we need to invest more in rural India and in small towns to drive in India's growth story. Rural India today has more active internet users than urban India. Most of the startups are from tier 2 and 3 cities. I request industry to invest more in rural, semi-rural sector. 21st century India economic growth will be powered by villages and small towns, Modi said. Going on to speak about the Atmanirbhar Bharat campaign, Modi said the government wants, in fact, industries in India to become independent and that the new production linked intensive scheme would help to do that in those sectors that will make India a global campaign. A decision government reduces hardness for others. The job of a decisive government is to contribute as much as possible to people of the country. India has marked manpower and capability to work with a mission mode. During pandemic, we have seen how working together can help others as well, Modi added. The PM Modi also defended the center recently passed agriculture reforms, which has resulted in widespread farmers' protest. Modi said that this law would break barriers in agriculture and increases farmers' income. If you place barriers, which previous governments did, an industry or sector cannot grow. The recent agriculture reforms are a part of the barrier breaking process. We are removing the barriers within agriculture, food processing, storage and cold chain, he said. Farmers will have access to new markets, their incomes will improve. The country's cold storage infrastructure will modernize. The biggest benefit carriers will be country farmers, especially the small marginal farmers. Okay, this was quite interesting and the time is 56 minutes, 4 minutes go. Within the 4 minutes, I'll read the best one. Okay, 4 minutes. Yes. Happily, I'm done this. I passed out 16. 11th, 12th, I done. 11. Worldwide news. I done. And business news also done. Oh no, here is the fourth page. 15, 3.5 minutes, we have sports page and explore page. We are going to this. I can't read, I think I have only exactly 3 minutes till now. So, I'll just read the headlines. Sports page, page number 13. In pink of heel the before test. In pink. Batsmen getting runs to go with form of bowler leave India in good stead against wounded ISIS. 6 unit missing in BCCI draft voter list. 6 units missing in BCCI draft voter lists. Will accommodate all IOC suggestions, Umar. Tata opens 21 unlikely. Poll list boost for pre-camp in AICF battle. Yes. Global updates. Jemison Rock Windies after injured post 460. Premier League goal in 20 seconds. London. Yes. Okay. I have only 2 minutes. 58 minutes have done. Hope you guys. I'm going to the last page for 2 minutes. It is exploring page. Can we get any interesting topic in this? UN chief to world leaders declare climate emergency. Smarter COVID-19 testing method on the horizon. Child looks up for total solar eclipse. Wow, nice. It's child. Giant iconic ice break on lost voyage. Feeling too heavy for comfort. Weight gain not healthy. Fact of the matter. Flamethrower for WASP control. Syria comes under fire. Syria. Okay. Arecibo telescopes fall indicative of global divide around funding science. How much was it previously? Environment. We have only 10 seconds at last. I am going to show you this. GRIM times le sundown. Yeah, I'm done. 1 hour. Oh my god, it's 1 hour from now. Yes, you can see the what child looks up for total solar eclipse. With this mission, we can see that. Okay, and now I'm going to show you that. I'm done 1 hour. Wait, oh no, wait. 1 second, guys. You can see this is 1 hour. I'm done. You can see that, right? Yeah. I'm done 1 hour newspaper reading challenge. Ooh, please do subscribe. It is very hard. Oh. For more this type of challenges, please hit the subscribe button. Love you. This motivation came from the Mr. Beast. He is my motivation and my favorite YouTuber ever, ever. Hi, Mr. Beast. If you are watching this video at the end, this moment, love you, bro. Bye-bye.